Green Thumb. What is that? Horticulturist?
Is your first impression will be he's adorable and you want to put him in your pocket, but he's a little shit. So he's hilarious. If you want to have a great time, you call Uncle Kerr.
He can make you laugh and make you want to choke him all at the same time.
Smelly. I'm kidding.
Kerr's been a good friend. I've known him for probably 3 years. And he's very fun, jovial character.
Flamboyant.
Oh. outgoing.
Sparkly.
Enormous.
Is that too much information?
Glittery.
Sexy.
Banana hands.
Banana hands.
Is that me then?
Yeah, it's
quite tough. Hi, okay. Talented.
Did you say vivacious?
No, oh, that's a good one. handsome. And warm and friendly.
Aww, we love you, Kerr.
Wow. He looks like a 15-year-old.
Yeah. Shiny. That's one.
Small.
Meticulous. Creative.
Still thinking. Yeah. I know, I have lots. It's the camera.
Witty. He's like a magnet. I think he's like gravity. I think people want to, they're pulled to him and they're drawn to his energy.
Childlike. Sincere. Well, I keep going back to painful because he's had a lot. And he's had to deal with a lot. And
his heart's been broken, but he's broken many a heart as well. Daryl, Deshaun, Darius, Darcy, Damien, Greg, Garcia, Gargamel, Grant, Jocelyn, Jamar, Jackal, Justin.
I'm sure, yeah, we all have our own crosses to bear. And, but that thorny cap really does it to you every so often. Very few people actually, you know, take the time to look behind the curtain and pay attention to the man that's behind it.
Oh.
Dill roll.
I've seen Kerr, you know, I thought he was straight for about an entire Sunday afternoon at the Lincoln Street Fest 2008. And you want to know why? Okay. So my friend Anne is a bisexual woman, and everybody's having a great time. Beers, shots at Farragut's, outside for beers, back to the street fest. Hairbanger's Ball is playing, 8 p.m. We are there, front and center. Having a good time. I turn around to see how my friends are doing, Kerr and Anne, who have just met, by the way, and they're having a great time, clearly, because they're making out. Really? So Uncle Kerr puts on his fox baseball cap turned backwards, and he turns into a straight boy. I didn't know. And yeah, full on, tongue action. I had the camera phone out, taking photos and texting them to everyone that we knew. So that was a shocker, and you know, he had a girlfriend for about 3 hours. And that was awesome. So my poor friend Anne developed a crush because she thought she had a boyfriend, and little did she know that, you know, he turned into a bottom by the next day.
First of all, the one story I wanted to tell was about Kerr and I burning our faces off from some chemical we ordered off of the internet, and
for what purpose?
To look younger. Kerr wants to look younger. He wants to be younger than he is. He's turning 30. That he's middle-aged now, so he really needs to start looking after himself.
No way.
He
needs to stay out of the sun, otherwise those wrinkles on his forehead are going to get larger into deep crevices, and then he's going to get Botox.
I've known Carrie, how long? 7 years. I'm Betty Baconfat, and
I'm Clairvoyant.
Mm-hmm. We worked at Ed's together, and we knew a little T. Diddy when he did a little number on the counter with the violin, a fake violin, a real one.
A fake. Well, it was real to him. It was real to him.
Oh God, I've known Carrie for a long time. Graduated high school in 98, and then I guess the fall of that year, I met him in Lincoln. So, 98, probably 11 years now.
Mm-hmm.
Became really good friends. I was very lucky to find somebody like him. I mean, moving away from home, being a big mama's boy, that was a big issue. I didn't really want to do it. Knew I had to, but didn't really want to do it. And I was going to college with kids from high school that I graduated with. But like, they were doing their own thing, and I was doing mine. Didn't have really much in common with those kids. So meeting Carrie, having a lot in common, the whole music, theater, stuff like that, it really helped.
5th grade band. I think Carrie's like the coolest guy ever, and he needs to borrow a read, and I literally jump out of my seat to give him the read. I have one! Take this one. And then he's like, you want this? I'm like, no, you can have it. Anything to get in with Carrie Markey. I would have given him my saxophone to play if that's what he wanted. And we really started to become friends probably my freshman year of high school. Second period computer class, and we hit it off like that, and from then on it was pretty much we were attached at the hip.
I hadn't met Carrie Markey yet. I saw him in Queer Tale 2006, but I was never introduced to him until I auditioned for the 2007 show, and I guess my first word would have to say confused, because, and Kelly Okono did this, his bio. And I remember seeing his bio in, basically, the end of the bio said, I'd like to thank my lovely girlfriend. And I'm sitting there the whole show saying, boy, is my gaydar off. Because who's this girlfriend and does she not know he's gay?
I met Carrie Markey. I was a freshman in college at Roosevelt University. And he was a junior transfer student. And I believe it was a keg party on the north side around Sheridan. And I think we knew who each other were, but we'd never actually talked. And, you know, we were getting wasted, getting drunk, you know, not that I condone that sort of thing or anything. But we were enjoying some beverages, as college kids do, and we found ourselves making out with each other. And so we're making out and stuff, and then I believe there was a little more stuff that happened once we got back to the dorm rooms. And then the next day, I never heard from him again. You know, he actually started to date this supermodel boy who is actually his roommate's ex-boyfriend. And it was very scandalous at the time. Very scandalous. Anyone who was there, you know how scandalous that was.
He worked in the theater office at Roosevelt University, and there was a show that I was required to go to, but apparently it was all sold out. And Carrie, I forget the circumstances, but he was somehow able to get me in to go see that show because he worked at the office. And so I liked him. At first, I liked him. Well, no, I never disliked him, but he kind of, I guess, maybe stole is the wrong word, but I'm going to say it anyway, stole my first, like, true love away from me, so. We didn't really talk to each other for a long time until he broke up with, I have called him the life ruiner before. And then all of a sudden we had something to talk about, and that's when we became really good friends, when we were sort of commiserating together about this stupid boy.